You have to consider the landscape in which we are operating. We are existing in the most competitive climate ever in this industry, and that is global competition. So we, you know, these decisions are made, like I said, they're made very last minute, and they can change on a dime, as you well know. And, you know, we can have productions that are on the ground here that are fully engaged, who can pull up stakes and go someplace else because...
And we sort of spoke earlier about an example of that. There was recently an Angelina Jolie movie that was looking at very seriously at Hawaii. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Based on the novel Unbroken, and it is a passion project of hers, and I think that we lost it to Australia for a variety of reasons, but incentives had a lot to do with it. There were some visa issues, as I understand, but again, the Australian government is serious about, you know, wooing this business from the States. A good example, the British Columbia Film Commission, this whole incentives game started as a result of production going north to Vancouver. And British Columbia Film Commission is the same age as the Hawaii Film Office. 1978, they were both formed. That is now a over $1 billion a year industry. And you compare the province to the state of Hawaii. But it is because the government, the provincial and the national government of Canada said, this is an industry that we're going to support. It is a good clean industry that provides those well-paying jobs, that has all of the promotional value as well. So there are huge benefits for the state, and I think we're in this game for the long haul.
You know,